Right, so I'm at the Memories Flamenco, just staying down the beach a bit at Memories Carib. This is sort of a family resort, lots of kids. Looks very busy this week, I guess being first week of summer vacation out. It's about 11 o'clock in the morning. You can see it's pretty busy here. There's the check-in counter on the left. It's got pretty nice waiting area here. You see lots of kids. It's a great place to bring the family and the kids. Here's some of the Sunwing check-ins. You can check on your flight or other excursions you might want. Okay, here's the bar area. You see they have a Route 66, the same branding as Memories Carib. This is the main lobby bar. Let's take a look at the bartenders. See lots of rum up there. All right. Can't go wrong with rum in Cuba. Or the coffee. The coffee's fantastic. Especially the Irish coffee or Spanish coffee, etc. Here we got the entertainment system here. Looks like they're under some kind of repairs. Not sure if they're doing shows this this week or not. Hopefully they are. All right, so let's keep rolling around here. Got kind of the main pool area. They got multiple pools, which is good. I was here another day later in the afternoon, and this the main pool here was rocking, good music, and all sorts of games going on to entertain the kids. Got a more kind of teenager kid level, but I'm sure everybody could participate. So, the music's a bit loud. Hopefully you can hear me over it. It's not too busy at the pool. Lots of chairs still available. You see, that's where the music entertainment's done up at that end. All right, we'll just keep walking around the pool, see what else we got here. We'll get to the beach in a bit, check out some of the restaurants and bars. There's multiple pools here. This one's kind of what I'd say the loud pool with the music blurring. So if that's what you like, it's good. Let's get back on the main pathway here. Also swing around to the right a bit here. You can see some of the accommodations. This would be the pool facing view. There's also ocean facing rooms, and it's the ocean views. If you're facing the ocean, is unobstructed. There's not really any vegetation or trees blocking, so you get a pretty good view if you're up second or third story. But my preference would be the ocean view, but other people like the pool view. All right, so just swing back there. That's the main kind of loud pool. There's another pool down there. We're going to get to that in a minute. Just going to swing into this little snack bar here. See what we got. Looks like alcohol. It's called Bites. I presume there's food in here as well, but not seeing anyone eating. Maybe it's kind of in between breakfast and lunch now. A little better bar stock here. Some vodka, rum, juice. But if you got kids, you gotta stay somewhat sober looking after them. All right, let's go back here and we'll check out the other other pool area here. I think there's three pools, if I recall. No, so I think there's a Diamond Club here. I'm going to check that out. Hopefully my wristband from Carib entitles me to the Diamond Club here. So we'll find out. A little chessboard, presumably bocce ball. Oh, table tennis. We got a little sports area here. Well, it tends to be underutilized, I find. Most people prefer to be in the pool or the ocean. Here we go. This must be the adult quiet pool. Yeah, it's a bit quieter here. You can see the swim-up bar. It's well-stocked. But they let the kids defend for themselves upstairs. Yeah, down here, almost nobody here. See some other accommodations down there, or perhaps those are restaurants. Actually, I'll check that out in a minute. So down the stairs here, and you can see in the distance there. That's the main. Main area, this is the pathway, just did sort of a circle here. We're gonna head out this way here. Hopefully this truck drives are usually pretty good. I haven't run me over yet. Well, I do recall when I was here yesterday there was another pool somewhere. Ah, here we are. Just hiding on me. Yeah, so here we've got, this is for the younger kids, a little splash pad. Seems to be completely underutilized right now. Looks like a nice pool, nice and clean. It's excellent condition. And here we have the childcare memories fun club. I guess you got some stuff inside you can do. Oh, here's an even smaller little pool over here. It's probably for toddlers. A little bit of sand here, some play structures. Unfortunately, I'm here at a bad time. It's like 11 o'clock. The buffet is not open, the restaurants, but you can see there's a number. It's Mediterranean style restaurant there. Had the Mediterranean at Carib, it was pretty good. Had the Italian as well, both of them were good. I would say better than the buffet offerings, which is not always the case, but I would say the a la carte was definitely an upgrade from the buffet. At an Asian restaurant up here on my left. We didn't try the Asian. I haven't had a Creole. I think we got Creole coming up this week at Carib. We'll see how that goes. Asian, I haven't had great luck with Japanese or Asian food in Cuba, so we skipped that this time. Okay, so now we're going to walk down to the beach here. If I can remember my way, yesterday I got a little bit, I wouldn't say lost, but disoriented. It's a pretty big resort here. You can see these rooms are three stories high. Actually, I'm gonna climb up here and just see what kind of view we can get from up top. Fairly big complexes. Three floors. Looks like 21 21 rooms per level. Let's go right up to the top here. Hopefully they got a staircase on the other end so we can check out the view to the ocean. All right, so you can see pool area. Zoom in a bit here. So the pool area is there. Got some smoke going on there. I don't know what's going on. All right, let's go down the hallway here. Looks reasonably fresh. I've noticed some of the buildings look like they're kind of closed for the off season, but this one's definitely close to the pool, close to the beach. These are the kind of premium rooms. They're going to keep them open. And looks like I miscalculated. This does not face the ocean. You can kind of see the ocean here. Yeah, maybe I will check out that other building and get a view of the ocean from there. Okay, so now we're walking towards this next building. I'll just teleport myself to the top there. Right up on the top here. Looks like there's no easy lookout. I see what they've done. These would be the premium rooms here, 5314, etc. These guys are gonna get the full ocean view. See what I can see. Oh yeah, actually this is the lagoon here. You can see it's a massive lagoon. You can see way in the distance there is Memories Carib. Okay, let's swing back this way. Got the ocean view here. Yeah, so again, these are the premium room numbers. I'm sure there's a upgrade. Oh, look at that. There's a walkway right to the beach from here. Perfect. And looking fantastic view of the beach. Just zoom in a bit on that. You can see there's another. Some birds gonna attack me again. Another building over there. Try to hold this steady on the zoom. Yeah, so this is the room that I'd be booking if I could. All right, so we're just exiting building 5 here. Yeah, I was looking up the site map online, figure out which rooms are gonna give you the best view. These guys are perfect because they're close to the pools, close to the beach boardwalk. And that's definitely a premium room. Now, when I took the other boardwalk on the way in, there was a beach bar. So a bit of a trade-off there. Be a little bit of a walk along the beach to get to the beach bar from this boardwalk, I believe. But, unless I've got a beach bar here as well, but I don't recall seeing one, but let's see, it doesn't seem to be here. So you can see the view is just fantastic. Lots of shade here. Very calm water. Every day we've been here, it's been windy, which is good. Keeps the bugs down, keeps the cools you down a bit because it's been kind of mid-30s, which is pretty hot. See like how big this beach is. Lots of chairs. It goes quite a ways. Let's take a little walk down here and I'll show you where the beach bar is. See, we got high tide here. Kind of tell by the where the little bit of grass is. No seaweed issues like you see in Dominican Republic, or even Jamaica now apparently is getting pretty bad seaweed. But, it's really one of the many benefits of Cuba over some of the other Caribbean destinations is the beaches are fantastic. And they're unspoiled too. Like they don't build on the beaches here. There's no motorboats. It's very tranquil and natural setting. Which, that's what you are into. That's good. You see here, they haven't even bothered putting out all the chairs here yet because there's nobody here. Of course, the beach attendants will bring your chair out for you, no problem. I've tripped over a sandcastle there. Here we are at the end here. And you can see here's where you can get your horse rides along the beach. Right, we just started back again. Seems I was a bit disoriented. The beach bar is actually to the right. I didn't notice that staircase when I walked by the first time on the beach. It's kind of hidden there. And so the beach bar is just up here on the right. It's pretty close, so I would say some of those places, some of those buildings along the beachfront are, especially the ones that are close to the main area, are pretty good. Hey, so anyways, if you enjoyed the video, please subscribe. I'm trying to get up to 1,000 subscribers. Got a ways to go yet. And if you like, please like. Any questions, shoot me a comment and I'll get back to you. So here's the beach bar up ahead here. You can see a couple more buildings in the background are also give you a pretty good ocean view. So check out the supply of alcohol up here. Hola, get some good rum and other spirits up here. Excellent. Hey, bartender.